Hey Cloud Gurus, welcome back to another AWS This Week. There's lots of goodies for you this week from AWS, which I've noticed all have to do with keeping your services running well. AWS Resilience Hub is now generally available. AWS Systems Manager Incident Manager is available in 7 new regions. And AWS Backup supports a few new services. It's AWS This Week with me, Nick Triantafillou. Kicking it off this week, AWS Resilience Hub is now generally available. Resilience Hub is a new service that provides you with a single place to define, validate, and track the resilience of your applications so you can avoid downtime caused by software or infrastructure disruption. You can define recovery time objectives and recovery point objectives and help validate that these targets can be met prior to deployment. It will also automatically assess and identify resilience weaknesses and provide recommendation solutions for your infrastructure. It's available right now in a bunch of different regions, and you can try it for free for 6 months for up to 3 applications. After that, it's just $15 per application per month. Next up, AWS Incident Manager from AWS Systems Manager is now available in 7 more regions. Specifically, Mumbai, Seoul, Central Canada, London, Paris, Sao Paulo, and North California. Incident Manager helps you prepare for incidents with automated response plans. An incident could be anything alerting in your own CloudWatch alarms, such as CPU usage alarms, storage capacity alarms, and so on. The Incident Manager console provides a unified interface to view operational data from multiple AWS services and track incident updates, alarm status changes, and response plan progress. With these additional regions, it's now available in 16 all up, so there's surely one close to you if you'd like to check it out. Finally this week, AWS Backup has added support for Amazon DocumentDB, which comes with MongoDB compatibility, as well as Amazon Neptune, a graph database. AWS Backup enables you to centralize and automate your data protection policies across your AWS services, and with these additions, you can use a single data protection policy to automate the creation of your snapshots of your DocumentDB and Amazon Neptune clusters across your AWS regions and accounts, and it even gives you the ability to restore those clusters with a single click. Very cool. All right, there's a few things that will keep your infrastructure running well and some options to assist in restoring them should any incidents occur. That's all for me this week. Keep being awesome, Cloud Gurus, and we'll see you next time.